Welcome to iHeartRadio Live with Cage the Elephant from the iHeartRadio Theater in L.A. Please welcome your host, Harms.
Hello and welcome to the iHeartRadio Theater in Los Angeles. My name is Harms and, well, people are listening on the radio right now at iHeartRadio. We want to say thank you to them. Say hello, hello, and thank you to them. Everyone streaming the show at iHeartRadio.com. And everybody here at the iHeartRadio Theater, that's cool too. Hello, hello. Tonight's band has been around since 2008. They got their start in Bowling Green, Kentucky. You can hear them coming up on the stage right now. They've had 5 number one songs. They just released a brand new record. We're going to talk to them all about it in just a little bit. We're also going to hear a bunch of songs from their entire catalog. Are you guys ready to get started? You want to get going? iHeartRadio Live presents right now, Cage the Elephant. Los Angeles, this is iHeartRadio Live. Matt, good to see you, man. How are you?
Good to see you as well.
We had a pool backstage on how long it would take for you to get into the crowd. I had 30 seconds, so I just won $100. Thank you very, very much, man. Absolutely. Congratulations on the new album.
Thank you.
Tell Me I'm Pretty is out now. Came out in December.
Thank you.
I read somewhere that that song, Mess Around, almost didn't even make it on the album. Is that
yeah,
true?
Yeah, well, Brad had been toying with the riff and was kind of uncertain if it would work out to be a song, and I heard it immediately, connected with it, and then we recorded it in the studio and almost got nixed, but it didn't, so there we go.
I'm glad it made it, man. It's a good one. Absolutely. the producer of this album, Dan Auerbach from the Black Keys. How did that happen? You've known Dan for a little while. Who approached who about making or working on a record?
Well, years ago, we supported the Black Keys when Brothers was really taking off, which was super cool to witness and see happen. And just befriended each other and stayed in touch. And then we supported them on the Turn Blue tour as well and had showed him some songs on a day off. And he sent me this real aggressive text message. I'm making your next record.
That's a good text message.
Yeah,
to get.
Tell you, that was it was awesome. It was welcomed aggression.
How did Dan help your band? Is there one thing that you can point out where like he really helped us here?
Dan has an incredible ability to keep you from getting in your own way or like self-sabotaging.
Yeah.
And so he also has a really strong grasp of like classic sound. There was this really cool thing that we would do. We would cut a track. And then we'd all go into the control room and listen to all kinds of different obscure music.
Sure,
and
yeah,
kind of
yeah.
Catch a vibe. And when we caught a vibe, then we would go back in and recut the song and it would give it a totally different feel.
Awesome, awesome. Well, congratulations on the album. You guys sound ready to go for another song, right? You guys ready? We got a rowdy group. I like it.
I
absolutely.
Like it too.
It's Cage the Elephant on iHeartRadio Live right now.
Did you stand there all alone? Oh, I cannot explain what's going down. I can see you standing next to me. In and out, somewhere else right now. You sigh, look away. I can see it clear as day. Close your eyes, so afraid. You can drive all night looking for the answers in the pouring rain. You wanna find peace of mind looking for the answers. Funny how it seems like yesterday as I recall. You were looking out of place. Gathered up your things and slipped away. No time at all. I followed you into the hall. Cigarette, daydream. You were only 17. So sweet, with the mean stink. Nearly brought me to my knees. You can try all night looking for the answers in the pouring rain. You wanna find peace of mind looking for the answers. If we can find a reason to change, looking for the answers. If you can find a reason to stay. You can drive all night looking for the answers in the pouring rain. You wanna find peace of mind looking for the answers. If we can find a reason to change. Looking for the answers. If you can find a reason to stay. Standing in the pouring rain. Thank you.
nice of you to go and send me on my way. I said, you're such a steel finger, why you do this to yourself? She looked at me and this is what she said. Oh, there ain't no rest for the wicked. Money don't grow on trees. Got bills to pay, I got mine to feed. Ain't nothing in this world for free. No, I can't slow down, I can't hold back. No, you know, I wish I could. No, there ain't no rest for the wicked. Tell me, close our eyes for good. Told him you can have my cash if you know I gotta estimate you wanna live this kind of life. Said there ain't no rest for the wicked. Money don't grow on trees. Got bills to pay, I got mouths to feed. Ain't nothing in this world for free. No, I can't slow down, I can't hold back. No, you know, I wish I could. No, there ain't no rest for the wicked.
Sitting in my house, the day was winding down and coming to an end. So I turned at the TV and flipped it over the news, and what I saw I couldn't. I saw a preacher man in Kelsey taking money from the church, stuffed his bank account with righteous dollar bills. But even still, I guess it must because I know we're all the same. Oh yes, we all gotta satisfy those thrills. No, there ain't no rest for the wicked.
KG Elephant, iHeart Live. We're at the iHeart Radio Theater in Los Angeles. The new record, Tell Me I'm Pretty, is out now. Who's seen Cage live before? You guys see him? This guy's crazy. This guy does some nuts stuff right here. Matt, when you come into a live venue like this, do you ever scout out places you're like, I can climb on that? That looks like a strong group of people that we can go jump in. Or is it all...
No, I try to surprise myself.
Absolutely. Like, if you came in here, where you were like, oh, those guys are rowdy.
I look for weak places in the crowd, and that's where I jump.
Very nice, yeah. Very nice. I was going to ask you to maybe give me a lesson if we wanted to go... No, we won't do that this time, but maybe. Tell Me I'm Pretty is the name of the song. My guess is that you didn't come up with that title literally. You're not asking people to tell you you're pretty.
Yes, we are. Yes. We really need to be accepted. No, we use the name because it kind of has, it's like, it has a tongue-in-cheek surface.
Sure.
But has kind of like a dark undercurrent. So, like, we live in the age of the selfie where everybody's constantly curating their lives and mostly just the high points. So it's kind of like an observation of that.
Absolutely, absolutely. Why did you guys release a coloring book with the album?
I don't know.
Out of all of the things that people have released with albums, a coloring book of all things, are those...
I like coloring books. I'm a horrible colorer.
I was going to say, do you guys color? Does everybody color?
Like, after we got the book done, I was like, I'm going to do really good, and I still can't color in the lines.
Yeah.
I always colored stuff like entirely too dark. I like wore the whole crown down after one picture.
Yeah, it clumps up in spots. You know, it's like looks crappy. You know the crappy colorer in school. That was me.
You guys are playing a pre Super Bowl show with Metallica.
Yeah.
Here in a couple of weeks. Are you guys football fans? Do you care about football?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Totally. Yeah.
Totally.
Brad and Titch and Jared are probably the biggest. Like,
who posted about
fans.
The Steelers the other day? Sorry, dude. know. I'm a Seahawks fan, man. I know all about it. But it's tough. Yeah. It's tough. Are you guys going to get to go to the game? Wait, hold on. We got a 49ers fan right here.
49ers fan.
Don't boo him. The next song you guys are going to do is called Trouble. It's on the new record. It is a very special song for you. Why does that song mean something special for you?
I was like having a conversation with a friend, and like it was a conversation that I think in the moment we were both like trying to be really transparent and honest. And, you know, after like reflecting on it, you kind of wonder how much of yourself you're really like putting into things. And so it's just kind of a song about transparency and adversity and like overcoming adversity and stuff.
Awesome. Well, we're excited to hear it. I have a feeling that you guys are excited to hear it. Are you ready? We got a big fan over there. It is Cage the Elephant. We are at the iHeartRadio Theater in Los Angeles. And this is iHeartRadio Live.
Here for Titchener. Thank you guys so much. We really appreciate everyone coming out very much.
Come on, Chopper.
Thank you. That was the greatest thing ever. I love you. I love this kid right here.
It's iHeart Live with KG Elephant at the iHeart Radio Theater. I agree with you 100%. We've had a lot of shows in this theater. That's never happened before. We've never had a stage dive. Let's give this guy a high five. Nice work. All right. Fellas, we got a rowdy crowd tonight.
Yes.
That's a lot of fun. You guys are real pumped about our friend Mr. Tishner over here.
I don't know what that is, though.
Do you
because Titch lays down the funky grooves.
But seriously.
Soulful.
Well, sometimes. You know these guys? Like, what's the deal over here?
I have no clue.
I love these guys.
They love you too, absolutely. So this spring, you guys are going out with some buddies, Silver Sun Pickups,
yes.
Foles, Bare Hands.
Yes.
There's a handful of tickets left for a handful of shows, but I mean, how excited are you for this tour?
Really, really stoked. We've toured a lot with all the bands that are on the bill, and it's going to be kind of like a family reunion or whatever, except for way more, like, demented, messed up. I don't know. Probably not. Yeah.
As you're starting the whole cycle again, is there any one place or any one group of people you're most excited in playing in front of? Maybe back home?
No. I mean, I don't know. Yeah, we just like to play shows. Yesterday was the first show that we played on the tour, and we were all, like, super giddy before the show. Like, we couldn't even wait for sound check because we just wanted to play.
So. I believe it. One last question. Do you have a favorite thing about the brand new record, Tell Me I'm Pretty? Is there something?
Like songs, highlights, or whatever?
Whatever.
For me, I really like the song Trouble, Too Late to Say Goodbye, Cry Baby. Yeah, I mean,
good enough.
How Are You True? Yeah.
Absolutely.
Actually, How Are You True? I was in New York and I was coming down the jet bridge to fly back home, and I bumped into this kid who was kind of like rummaging through his things. And I don't know, for some reason I looked at him, he just like reminded me of a younger self, a younger
sure.
me. And so I thought, man, I'm supposed to talk to this kid. And so I got on the plane and he sat down right beside me and we started having a conversation. He told me about a lot of the things that were going on with him at that time. Anyways, so we exchanged contact and we weren't ever able to connect. But I wrote the song How Are You True to see actually how he was, to know, so he would know that, like...
Well, maybe he's listening or watching right now. If you are, absolutely say hello.
Sure, I hope you're doing good.
Fellas, thank you so much for being here. Absolutely. It's KG Elephant. Let's hear it for him one more time. The new record, Tell Me I'm Pretty, is out now. We have one more song in our radio broadcast. You guys ready for that? It's iHeart Radio Live. Here we go.
Do you understand?
Thank you.
It's iHeartRadio Live with Cage the Elephant. We're at the iHeartRadio Theater in Los Angeles. The radio broadcast is over, but the live stream continues. We got another half hour to go. Here they are, Cage the Elephant.
The passers by crawling all over one another, trying to get ahead in life. Money comes, who we try, when we live, what if we die? You say that I'm insane, I say you're probably right. We all got something important to say, but talking's a waste. We'll be right back.
much. Hey, just real quick, be careful when you're throwing people over the barricade, because most of the time there's not someone here to catch them, and we don't want to see somebody get really hurt. Everybody have a good time, but let's not hurt each other. All right, thank you. Thank you. Thank you so very much.
We really appreciate being here. I want to thank iHeart for having us out. Shall we continue? Song, is that cool?
Oh, my precious ember burning. Sweet glowing light. From the moment I first saw you, I was yours and you were mine. Deep down we both knew you were trouble by design. And the echo of my mother's words, baby, don't you play with fire. To run. the sound of sirens circling around. Forced to watch the ashes floating, softly drifting to the ground. Deep down we both knew you were troubled by design, and the echo of my mother's words, baby, don't you play with fire. Settle down, just the two of us forever. Go on and surround, go on and surround, around.
This is Jay Champ. He's gonna lay down the funky beat for you guys. This next song is about L-O-V-E love. Hit it, Jared. We'll be right back.
Supposed to be right there. Cage the Elephant live at the iHeartRadio Theater. Thank you so much for being here. You can get more information about the band at iHeartRadio.com/CageTheElephant. If you're tweeting, if you're Facebooking, if you're any of that, use the hashtag iHeartCageTheElephant. Their latest record, Tell Me I'm Pretty, is out now. Thank you so much for being here. That's not up to me. Thank you so much for being here. It's Cage the Elephant. My name is Harms. Have a great night.